Good morning, student. I Purna welcome you to my class of English. And I'm going to do the last part of the best Christmas present in the world, written by Michael Moore Forgo. So we have already discussed about this lesson, student. And in this lesson, I'm going to tell you, in fact, the important point of the lesson I will be discussing with you. The author went to a junk shop in Bridport. He noticed a roll-top desk. It was very old and made of oak. It was in a bad condition. It had burn marks down one side. Since it was cheap and it was within his budget, so it was the author who thought that he would buy it and he would get it repaired by himself only. He began working on it on Christmas Eve. He removed the roll top and tried hard to pull out the drawer. It had suffered much damage due to fire and water. The drawer was jammed. He hit it hard with his fist and pulled it out. He found a secret drawer underneath. He took out a small black tin box. There was a note on it that said, Jim's last letter received January 25, 1915. The letter writer also wished to put it in her grave. Out of curiosity, though he knew that it was not a good thing to read somebody's letter, but then he thought, he was so curious to read it, that he took that letter out from that black tin box and he started reading it. And children, there was a note on that box says, Jim last letter received January 25, 1915. The letter writer also wished to put it on her grave. Out of the curiosity, he opened the box. Inside it, he found an envelope with the address, Mrs. Jim MacPherson, 12 Copper Beaches, Bridport, Dorset. The letter was dated 26 December 1914. So what was the date written on the letter? 26 December 1914. It was the date written on the letter. So the letter had been written to children. I know and I have told you in the previous video also that this letter, children, this letter was the date which is written on the letter, that is 26 December 1914. This was the date when the First World War was taking place, and I told you Jim MacPherson, he was the commanding officer of British Army, and he was involved in the war with the Germans. And I told you, students, that Fritz were known to German. They were known German soldiers. They were known as Fritz, and British soldiers. They were known as Tommy. British soldiers. Okay, so if they were known as Tommy, he was known as Tommy. Now, he took out. So, student, I was telling you, the letter had been written by Jim to his wife Connie, and he was a soldier set against the Germans during the First World War. So, who was his Mrs. Connie's husband? It was Jim MacPherson, and the letter had been written by Jim MacPherson. The letter had been written by Jim MacPherson. And it was her wish also that it should be put in her grave. And children, now let me tell you something about Jim MacPherson. Who was he? So Jim MacPherson was a soldier set against the German during the First World War. Jim wrote to her that he was very happy because something wonderful had happened. Okay, so children, it was Jim had written to his wife, and he was a soldier in the British Army, which went to fight with Frist in the First World War. So from there he wrote a letter to his wife that that he was very happy because something wonderful had happened. The soldier on both sides of no man's land were taking a position in their trenches. It was Christmas morning, cold and frosty. Jim saw the German soldier waving a white flag. They were calling out the English soldier to say Happy Christmas. So children, this I have already discussed with you that children, Jim saw the German soldiers waving in white flag when the both parties were ready to fight with each other. Fritz, that is German soldier, fighting with Tommy, that is a British soldier. So children, both the army that day, it was on the day of Christmas, Jim saw the German soldier waving a white flag towards them. They were calling out the English soldiers to say Happy Christmas. It was a big surprise to be greeted like friends by the enemies, but it was true, not a trick. The English soldier also wished them in return. The leader said that they wanted to celebrate the festival. Jim was the officer in command. So both the party, they did not want to fight with each other. They wanted to celebrate the festival. So Jim was the office in the mid. He allowed his men to join the German. Grey coats and khaki coats were mingled in the middle. Now let me tell you the story scenario of grey coats and khaki coats. So children, grey coats were the army of German army. That is the Fritz were known as grey coats. Khaki coats. And grey coats were put by Tommy, that is a British soldier. So this is the story. Who wore khaki coats? It was Germans who put khaki coats, and it was British soldier who put grey coat. Mingled in the middle. So both the team, the uniform were mingling. Mingling means mix. They were so happy. They were meeting, wishing each other Merry Christmas, enjoying, drinking, eating. Okay, so it was really... he felt it was not a trick, but it was a true. The English soldier also wished them in return. The leader said that they wanted to celebrate the festival. Jim was the officer in command. He allowed his men to join the German. Grey coats and khaki coats mingle in the middle. In the time of war, they were making peace. The German soldiers who came first was named Hans Wolf. Before joining the army, he used to play the cello in an orchestra. Jim had been a school teacher in Dorset. Now children, both the commanding officer, the name of the commanding officer of German, I told you, was Hans Wolf, and here he is the commanding officer for for Britishers. So both they exchanged their views, they started talking with each other, and Hans Wolf told that before joining the army, he used to play the cello in an orchestra. So what is a cello? Cello is a musical instrument. So before joining the army, he used to play cello in the orchestra. Jim had been a school teacher in Dorset. And Jim, a school teacher in Dorset. Dorset is a place in England. Hans lied that he knew Dorset well. In fact, he had read about that place in Hardy's novel, Far From the Madding Crowd. Now, children, when Jim asked Hans Wolf that did he hear about Dorset, so he told no, he had heard about Dorset, but at the same time, he felt that he is telling lie. Jim MacPherson felt that he is telling lie. In fact, it was not Dorset, it was... he was the English soldier also. He wished on both the side. he knew that the English soldier, he knew that the heart is, he had read from Hardy novel Far From the Maddening Crowd. The soldiers from the rival campus smoked, laughed, drank and feasted. So both were enjoying. Okay, they were laughing, they were smoking, they were drinking and they were celebrating Christmas. Hans said that he liked the marzipan, the sweet covering on Jim's bread. Now children, a special cake was prepared for Christmas by Conny, Jim's wife. And Hans told that he liked that, the marzipan. It was prepared by Conny, especially for Jim for the Christmas. So children, both the parties, they enjoy. Okay. Fen, the soldier from the rival camp smoked, laughed, drank and feasted. Hans said that he liked the marzipan, the rival, the sweet covering on Jim's bread. Jim wrote in the letter that he had never seen or imagined a Christmas party like that. They played football. Also, both agreed on one point. The country should have better resolved their disputes by playing a football or cricket match. Now, this is very important point, children. The country should have better resolved their disputes by playing a football or cricket match, because no one dies in a match, whereas war leaves behind orphans and widows. Now children, war, they leave behind. Now children, both the parties, both the armies of German and British, they were in favor of solving the war by playing the cricket match or football match, because no one dies in the match and no children become orphaned and no wife become widow. Well, finally the game was also finished. So did the drinks and cakes. Jim told Hans that they hoped to see families as soon as the fighting ended by Christmas next year. The author put the letter back into the envelope and drove into Bridport. He meant to hand over the letter to Conny, Mrs. MacPherson. Now children, after reading this letter, he knew that how important this letter is for Mrs. Conny MacPherson. And children, he took a decision. What decision he took? He definitely, he will hand over this letter to Mrs. Jim MacPherson. Alright. And he put the letter back into the envelope. Took out his car, drove into Bridport, which was near his city only. He mean to hand over the letter to Conny, Mrs. MacPherson. Conny was now 101 years old. Her house had caught fire, but when he reached there from the neighbor, there was nothing but a burnt house. So he asked the neighbor about the whereabout of Mrs. Conny MacPherson. So he told he now their house were burnt. And now she has left that house. She has gone. She was in a conservatory now. The author wished her happy Christmas and gave the letter to her. She recognized the writing of her husband and felt very happy. She mistook the author for Jim, who had come home as promised on Christmas. She kissed the author on the cheek and asked him to read the letter to her. She wanted to listen to the voice of her husband. She said that he himself was the best Christmas present to her. Now children, she imagined when he handed over that letter of her husband, she feel that it is her husband who has come back again, and she is thanking God by telling that is the best Christmas present she had ever had. So children, this is all, the best Christmas present in the world, written by Michael Morpurgo. Now children, I will be doing your NCERT textual question book, question answer. Okay. So question answer, which is there on page number 10. What did the author find in a junk shop? What did the author find in a junk shop? So the author found a rolled up deck for sale in a junk shop. Okay. It was made of oak wood, but it was in a very bad condition. The author found a rolled up deck for sale in a junk shop. It was made of oak wood, but it was in a very bad condition. In the secret drawer of the desk, the author found a small tin box. It had a letter in it. I think the owner of the roll-top desk might have put it there. So what did he found in a secret drawer? Who do you think had put it in there? In the secret drawer of the desk, the author found a small tin box. It had a letter in it. I think the owner of the roll-top desk might have put in there. Now, the comprehension check, which is there on page number 14. Well, who had written the letter to whom and when? So, it was Jim McPherson. He was a captain in the British Army, had written this letter to his wife Connie when he went for a war. And the letter was dated December 26, 1914, to his wife Connie. So he had written that letter when he went for a war. Okay, the letter described. Now question number 2. Why was the letter written? What was the wonderful thing that had happened? The letter described a wonderful event. The two armies, the British and the German, fighting against each other, celebrated Christmas together. Now third, what jobs did Hans Wolff and Jim McPherson have when they were not soldiers? Before joining the army, Hans played the cello in the orchestra. Cello is a musical instrument. So he was a cello player in the orchestra. Jim was a school teacher. He was a teacher. Had Hans Wolff ever been to Dorset? Why did he say he knew it? So, children? No, Hans had never been to Dorset. He had never been to Dorset. He had only read about Dorset in Hardy's novel, Far From the Maddening Crowd. Do you think Jim McPherson came back from the war? How do you know this? No, Jim McPherson never came back home from the war. Perhaps therefore his wife Connie had preserved the letter. In fact, what I feel, he died in the war. Because after that he did not hear anything and he died in a war. Okay, so why did the author go to Bridport? The author went to Bridport to meet Mrs. Jim McPherson and deliver to her Jim's letter. How old was Mrs. McPherson now? Where was she? Mrs. McPherson was 101 year old now. She was in a nursing home. Who did Connie McPherson think her visitor was? Now these are question answers from page number 16. So Connie McPherson thought, who did Connie McPherson think her visitor was? Connie thought that the visitor was her own husband, Jim McPherson. Because children, there's 2 points. First of all, it was evening time. Second, she was too old. She was not able to see. Due to her age, her visibility has also weakened down. So she thought that the narrator is her husband. Which sentence in the text shows that the visitor did not try to hide his identity? The sentence is, you told me you would come home by Christmas, dearest, she said, and here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim dear, sit down. Okay. So, working now, children, some question answer from page number 16. Okay. For how long do you think Connie had kept Jim's letter? Give reason for your answer. Children, Connie had kept Jim's last letter till January 25, 1915. This letter was dated 26 December 1915. 14. Why do you think the decks had been sold and when? The decks must have been sold when Coney House had burned. The table had been damaged by fire as well as water, and she has to leave her house. So definitely she cannot take all the furniture from her house to the conservatory where she was living. Why do Jam and Hans think that games or sports are good ways of resolving conflicts? Do you agree? A very nice and interesting question, student. So both Jim and Hans were soldiers. Both were warm-hearted. They had seen the suffering of war, so it was natural for them to hate war. They favored a peaceful solution to settle disputes. Games or sports, they said, were a good way of resolving conflicts. I also quite agree with them. Do you think the soldiers of the two armies are like each other or different from each other? Find evidence from the story to support your answer. All human beings are alike in many ways. They love peace and hate war. They want to live together. Example from the story, then they were calling out to us from across no man's land. Happy Christmas, Tommy. Happy Christmas. When we had got over the surprise, some of us shouted back, same to you, Fritz, same to you. So, children, this is there. Mention the various ways in which the British and the German soldiers become friends and find things in common at Christmas. The British and the German soldiers belong to different camps. They were enemies in wartime, and after all, they were human beings, and therefore they had similar feelings. They shared the festive spirit of the Christmas. They got over hatred and played games, feasted and drank like good friends. Both hated war. Both were anxious to go back to family at the end of the war. What is Connie's Christmas present? Why is the best Christmas present in the world? Connie thought that Jim had come back to home from war. She mistook the author as Jim. She had been waiting for her husband Jim. So the coming home of Jim was the best Christmas present in the world for her. Do you think the title of the story is suitable for it? Can you think of any other titles? Well, what I feel, decidedly the title of the story is the most suitable. It is the most apt title. For the old Connie, no other present could have given her such joy as the coming home of Jim, her husband. Her perception might be wrong, but she got the greatest happiness of her life. Since the story revolves around Christmas, the alternate title of the story could be War and Peace or Christmas Gift, but neither can be matched to the present title. So, children, this is all. Now, well, children, some adjective for element: elephant, enormous, striped, wild. Face is cheerful, round, chubby. Building is circular, large, multicolored, multi-story. Water is blue or cold. Now, one question is there for the writing section. Imagine that you are Jim. You have returned to your town after the war. In your diary, record how you feel about the changes you see and the event that occurs in your town. You could begin like this: 25 December 1919. It's Christmas today, but the town look dash dash dash. So you can write something, children. It's Christmas today, but the town looks very much different from what I had imagined. It had been ravaged by war, but it was quite cold and frosty morning. Buildings are in ruins and there's a graveyard. Silence everywhere. My own house burned when it was hit by a bombardment. The events of war have taken a toll on civilian as well as soldier. I hate the fighting instinct in us and curse the war mongers. Can't believe in peace like brothers. And children, you can elaborate, you can write your own ideas. Now, some of the additional questions which I am going to discuss here. Okay. So, how did the author find Jim's letter? What did it contain? The author found Jim's letter in the small black tin box put in the drawer of an old table. Jim's letter was addressed to his wife. He was a British soldier, but he was glad to have celebrated Christmas together with the German soldiers. He put down his thought in the letter and promised to come back home on Christmas. Jim talks about an incident that had just happened at the front. What was it? England and Germany were at war with each other. The British soldiers were waiting in school to school the German soldier. But on Christmas, a strange development took place. The German soldiers came out of their hiding place and called out Happy Christmas. They were unarmed. They waved a white flag. The British soldiers, led by Captain Jink McPherson, agreed to celebrate the festival together. Who are Fritz and Tommy in the story? So, as I told you, Fritz are the German soldiers. They used to put khaki uniform, and Tommy were the British soldier. They used to put grey uniform. Then, describe and weave the author meeting with Connie. Interesting question. Connie or Mrs. McPherson was 101 years old. When the author took Jim's letter to her in a nursing home, so she became very excited. Her eyes lit up and she mistook the author for her husband. She kissed his cheek. She said that she had been reading his letter every day, but she wanted to hear his voice. She had also made a Christmas cake for him, as he had promised to come home. She thought that he had come back home. She called his presence as home as the best Christmas presents for her in the world. What had happened to Mrs. McPherson? Describe her condition. So Mrs. McPherson lived alone after husband Jim McPherson went to join the British Army. We don't know whether he died or what happened to him, but army during the First World War. One day her house caught fire, but she was saved by the firemen. From them, she had been in a nursing home for treatment. She had grown extremely old and could not walk on herself, and her life got confined to a wheelchair. Okay, so this is all the law question. Now, some most important question we can discuss, like, why did the author decide to buy the roll top desk? And it was his wish to buy the roll top desk since long, and since it was very expensive, okay, he could not afford it. So one day he noticed a roll top desk. It was very old and made of old oak wood also. It was in a bad condition. It had burn marks down the one side. But it was cheap, but then also the author decided to buy it, though the shopkeeper told him that it was from 19th century, but he told me, okay, no matter, he would repair it, okay, and he would buy it. Describe the condition of the roll top deck at the time of the author bought it. The condition of the roll top deck, the author bought it, it had burn marks one side, it was very old, okay, and it was damaged from water also. Without repairing it, one side of the leg was also not up to the mark. Anyhow, it was pasted there. Describe the condition of the roll top deck at the time the author bought it. Okay, who wished a happy Christmas first and to whom? It was German soldier who wished Merry Christmas to the British soldiers first, and at first German British soldiers, they were not able to believe it. They thought it is a trick of some kind. Okay. And finally, children, they got the response from German British soldiers also. They both were involved in celebrating the Christmas together. They played, they eat, they drank. Okay, so many things they have done together. In the night, they sang Christmas carol also. How did the British and the German soldiers view war and game? So children, British and the German soldiers, they did not like war at all. Okay. Though they were enemies, but they were all human beings. They were having similar feeling. They shared the festive spirit of the Christmas. They did hate war. They felt that many people are died in a war. Many wives become widowed and many children are orphaned. They got over hatred and played games, feasted and drank like good friends. Both hated war. Both were anxious to go back to their family at the end of the war. And they feel game is the best way to decide who will be winning and who will be losing war. In what condition did the author find house number 12 in which Mrs. MacPherson was expected to live? So, Mrs. MacPherson lived alone after her husband died. From the address, he knew about the address from the letter which he had read. It was Bridford. So children, when he read the letter, he had a guilty conscience and he thought this letter should be handed over to Connie MacPherson. He took out his card, he drove to Bridford, and after showing that address, one boy told him that that house you can find there. But when he went there, unfortunately that the house was burned. Nobody was there in the house. So from them, she had been in a nursing home for treatment. No, see, children, somebody had told that he went to his neighbor. He told that she had gone to nursing home for the treatment. So there he went there, and finally children, when he handed the letter to her, okay, Connie, who was 101 year old, the author took Jim's letter to her in a nursing home. She became very excited. Her eyes lit up and she mistook the author for her husband. She kissed the cheek. She said that she had been reading this letter every day, but she wanted to hear his voice. She had also made a Christmas cake for him, but she wanted to hear his voice. She had also made a nice Christmas cake for him and she took him as her husband. She thought that Jim had come back home. She called his presence at home as the best Christmas present in the world. So children, this is all. Now, in the long question, children, summary can come. You have to write the summary. I've already discussed this letter several times. This I have discussed with you. Then children, in the long question, how you have to write the long question, this also I'm telling you. In the long question, no scribbling should be there. Point should be written very clearly. At least 3 to 4 paragraphs should be there. A child should know 3 paragraphs should be there. At least you can also write 4 paragraphs if you can, but not less than 3. Then only it will become under the category of long question. And children, one more thing, children, you should know which paragraph you should write first, which paragraph you should write next. Okay, sequence is very necessary. So with this, I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.